Hey you guys, Eddie Collins here for Hobby W's. Wanted to go ahead and actually chat about something that, I don't know about you guys, but like me, I love 6-volt cars. A couple of my cars are actually still original 6-volt, but let's face it you guys, the older they are, even if you've got good wiring, unfortunately, they just don't seem to be as bright or bright enough for people on the road. And it's always kind of scary, at least for me, if I'm driving my high roof, you know, and obviously you're going really early in the morning, you think to yourself, oh man, it's gonna be dark. Hopefully people are actually gonna be able to go ahead and see me, you know, whether it's my tail lights or the other one that's always fun is when you've got a passenger that's never been in your car and they always ask, are your headlights on? And you say, yeah, they're on. And it's as if you're driving in the dark. Anyway, wanted to go ahead and chat about some options for you guys. So like I said, I'm not a hardcore purist, but I just don't really wanna change my car from 6-volt. I mean, it's original paint, original this, original that. But so there are some really cool options because, for example, like my high roof, even though it's 6-volt, it's got disc brakes in the front. So, you know, little stuff just to be safe. And when we're talking safety, let's definitely talk about visibility. So I want to kind of share with you some of the, you know, some of the research that we've done, which is kind of cool. When you're talking about U.S. headlight assemblies, I think we talked about it in another video where you've got the clear lens and then you've got some of the lenses for the European headlights that are fluted lenses. Well, when you've got the US like we do here in the US, you can actually go ahead and run, you know, something really cool like the H4 bulb, which is actually going to go ahead and just pop right into your housing. And then on the backside, that's where you're actually going to put the actual bulb. This is more the glass and the reflector. This little booger here is a reflector, and I'll show you in a second how the bulb goes in, because normally we're accustomed to having the sealed beam. This is what, you know, we primarily see here in the US, and this is one unit. You know, there's your connectors there, and you know, that's it. So you plop this thing in here, and boom, you know, it's ready to rock and roll. However, on Shin's car, for example, we've gone ahead and actually gotten this, and it's a Hella, which is nice. I mean, you can still get this. Most of you guys in Europe, you guys are totally familiar with this because you have this. This is, you know, the H4 housing here. Now, the cool part about this is the fact that you could just go ahead and open it up and take your halogen bulb like this. And if you look carefully, you'll notice that it basically has the same exact setup as a sealed beam does, you know, the three connectors, so it'll go ahead and plug right into your socket just like it normally would. However, the halogen bulb is much, much brighter. And when you look at the halogen bulb, I mean, obviously it looks a little bit more intricate. And then we're gonna put up a diagram in a little bit to show some other details. But for now, the way that this actually works, as discussed before when we were chatting about European headlights, these will actually only go a certain way, so they're actually aligned properly when you go to put it in your car. So as you put it in, you start looking for the notches, and eventually you'll figure out which one goes where. And then you simply bring this over, bring the clips over, bring the little arm over it, and then boom, it's like this, if you will, you know, very similar. What's interesting though is how this one is convex as I drop it, and this one isn't as much, but they look really cool. And as we said before, it's kind of hard to see inside, but there's a reflector in there right in the center, and so the light will actually bounce off the reflector, and then it'll actually go ahead and hit this the giant refractor, I guess you could call it, that will actually send out the beams of light. And these flutes, the fluted lens here is made specifically to go ahead and direct that light a certain way, whether you have a left-hand drive or a right-hand drive car, just so you're not blinding oncoming traffic. I mean, in some places, obviously in Europe, you know, you can go ahead and be fined for it if you've got the wrong ones on and you're blinding oncoming traffic. So that's what you have when you have H4. Now let's just say, hey, you know what? I know the H4, it works pretty well for me, but what I think I wanna do is I want it to be just maybe a little bit brighter and still obviously retain, you know, my 6-volt electrics. So what do? Well, you go the LED way. And with LEDs, there are a lot of choices. And when you guys go online, you've got to be very, very careful as to what you get, because you actually might get the wrong thing. Now, we're going to put a link up to show the ones that we're actually using here. And this, there's actually some weight to this right here. One of the most important things that you need to do is be sure that you get the correct profile. Because if you don't get the correct profile, you're going to be either shining light right into oncoming traffic, or believe it or not, it might be brighter, but it's actually not directing a beam of light the way that you want it to go. So it kind of goes against what you're trying to do. You're trying to be, you know, efficient, obviously, but you're trying to go ahead and get better visibility so you see where you're going. Now, as you're looking at this here, you're actually gonna notice that you've got, let's set this down here. On the top part of the light here, you'll see this little section here that looks like a little sail, if you will. On this, it's gonna be the same way. So it's gonna go ahead and pop into the headlight in the same fashion. And so you can actually see the profile, the distance, length, everything about it is gonna be very similar. So it's compatible to your housing. If you notice here, this is the ultimate place where you're actually gonna go ahead and plug it in. Once again, when you're looking at this, you know, it's gonna go ahead and be a three prong. So it's gonna be exactly the same. It's gonna plug into your headlight plug, but all of the slack is basically what's gonna go ahead and allow you to go ahead and run the LED lights. So once you get this, like I said, it's pretty nice. It's some serious heft to this. You go, and it almost looks like maybe perhaps it wouldn't actually fit in here, but it does. It doesn't hit or anything like that. And you want to go ahead and make sure that you've got your prongs in correctly. And then once you do, then you basically bring the wires over. And that's what's nice about these, is the fact that the wires will go right around it. Okay. Didn't want to bore you with me putting this thing on. So anyway, basically you put this little booger on there like that, take the other one, bring it around, and there you go, you guys. This thing's now being held on just the way that the halogen bulb is. And it's in there nicely, firmly, and it's not hitting, obviously, the reflector. Now you're ready to rock and roll. So you take this and you go ahead and you put it into your bucket just like you normally would. You wanna make sure that it's gonna go ahead and be upright. So obviously for our type 1 friends out there, you want it to go ahead and, you know, be straight upside, up and down. And of course, you always want to go ahead and run your ring here. So once you've got that, put it in. And these rings, I always tell people, because a lot of the times they go to mess them up. And you want to make sure that before you start bending and tweaking things, take some time, have a little bit of patience, and plop it in there properly. And then you've got your springs. It was kind of funny just before when we were messing around with this, taking it off. It was hilarious because I thought Shin was gonna lose an eyeball. I mean, this sucker went flying and went up on the roof, so that sucker's gone. But anyway, you wanna be really careful when you're putting these on. Usually what I'll do is I'll hold the opposite end. There we go. So anyway, we didn't wanna bore you guys. Now, one of the things that I wanna point out is that these little notches here that you'll notice on these clips, they're there for a reason. There's a lot of difference in these. So listen, if you're taking your headlight apart, I would say pay attention to the way you take it apart so you can put it back together the same way. Again, always be careful. So you see that little notch? It's fitting right there on the edge of the ring. And then of course, this is going underneath the lip. This is when you, like I said, you wanna be careful, because when you start putting tension here, that sucker will come up and it could spring up on you. But once you get it on there, ta-da, it's there. So there we go. Finished product, not too bad. And then of course, this is where your parking bulb is. So before you go ahead and you put it in, you wanna go ahead and put your parking bulb on. And obviously this, you're gonna go ahead and leave it as a regular incandescent bulb. But the nice part is that once you're ready to rock and roll and actually install it, you put the headlight beam on sub. You put this over here. Plug it in, plugs in very easily. And then after you put on the little parking bulb assembly, let's see here, where's my screwdriver? Bum, bum, bum. just to show you guys. Once everything's tucked in there nicely, then you can just go ahead and clip it up at the top, and then everything fits in nice and neat. And it's ready to go. So that basically will show you what it looks like. And what's cool is the fact that, I mean, you know, it's, you still have a US headlight assembly, but what's nice is you've got the visibility, you've got the safety factor, which is huge. And I think in another video, we're also gonna be covering taillights for you guys, because that makes a big difference too, especially when you have snowflake taillights, or for the early bus guys, anything from 61 and down, you wanna be seen. All right, you guys. So we went ahead and put the assembly in. There's your parking light. And look at that. That is nice. That is very, very bright. I mean, that's 6 volt, you guys. And so right against the door here, you can see the difference between the high beam and the low beam. And you can see that it's a nice beam. I mean, it's very, very, very clear. And obviously it's directed properly, so you can actually drive safely. So pretty cool. I like the look of it too. Kind of nice. All right, you guys. So it's time to go ahead and change yours out. Time to be safe on the road. Thanks for watching, you guys.